Well met. Are you sure? The blade and just...
Yes? As you wish.
Ravengard's a hero. Eltonel would still be stuck in the Helms if it weren't for him.
Have you seen the tieflings at the South Gate? Elturel's exiles, cast out by their own city. Your precious hero liberated them from one hell only to trap them in another.
Wasn't he a fun when he looked after him?
Fellows, a few haystack short of a stack.
What do you want? I don't need to escape. I've got food, water, privacy, and I mean to keep it that way.
You're too late. It's over.
Floric? Oh, what have they done to you?
I don't speak of myself, High Harper. I speak of the city itself. We came too late. It's over. The Steel Watch happened. I came seeking allies to our cause. Watchers spotted me, dragged me to Alder Ravengard's husk, empty as a stair. A tadpole's puppet. Nothing more. He spoke in accusations. Apostasy. Conspiracy. Sedition. I'll be executed in 5 dawns.
Can go hang themselves. We're getting you out.
When the people need a miracle, you cannot wait for the gods to answer. Alder's words. I'd almost forgotten. No more sulking. I know what to do. Unlock my cell. Escort me out of Worm's Rock. I'll seek out my connections. When the city streets shatter, you'll want their blades. Hurry.
On your way.
Like a...
Keep focused. We can talk once I'm...
Should mind my step.
Two more legs for smashing. Oh, I'd love to see that thing in action.
This is far enough. The way should be clear. I can't thank you enough for getting me out of that damned prison and for giving me courage when I'd all but run out.
Don't be so quick with your gratitude, Counselor. All we have done is send you back into the battle.
And reminded me why I fight in the first place. Truly, thank you. When the flames roared loudest, you pulled me to safety. Most would have let me burn. I won't forget it. I will travel to the upper city, find what allies I can. You won't fight the coming battle alone. As long as the city stands, I will stand with it. This is my promise.
On my own job and leave the steel watches to them.
Did I tell you? A momentous occasion. I'm sure you agree. And to think, the drama's just started. You see, Gortash has had Will's father relocated. I'm just an impartial observer. This is Gortash's game. A murderous one, the way I hear it. Raven Guard's good as dead. And to think, there's no way to save him. Or is there? I know enough. Let's talk to Will in your camp. Work something out. The Duke's life depends on it.
By order of Lord Gortash, all livestock admitted to the city
must be surrendered. All livestock is now
if Ravengard had trained the fist proper, they'd be out catching crooks, not turning a blind eye. If you're here to report something, don't bother. The fist don't give a damn.
About time. The Manip assured me a builder would come around a 10-day ago and... Hold it. You're not the builder. Which means I've got no use for you. I need someone with a little more know-how. Hooligans at the Mermaid have been using my shutters for target practice. And that's not the half of it. I've had to replace the same window 3 times now, not to mention the mess they've made of my front door. Now either you learn to fix my broken shutters, or you wag your tongue elsewhere.
Times do I need to say it? You sent word about a league, said that I should come see you about it.
Of course, madam. Let me just... Forgive me, why are you here?
Is this some kind of sick joke? Do you have any idea what I've been through these past few days? My daughter Vanra, my little girl, she's missing. This stupid, useless fist said she had a lead, but she must have been sucking dream mist or something.
Madam, tell me. You said she was taken from a tavern?
You catch the barest tendrils of magic coiled around the flaming fist.
Yes, the blushing mermaid down by the docks. I told you 100 times. Why aren't you listening?
Someone or something has tampered with her memory.
What were we discussing?
What is happening? I feel like I'm going mad!
Nonsense, I'm fine. Madam, tell me why you're... here, and I will assist.
Got you right. Something's wrong with her. Can you help me? I've no family, and Vanra's father isn't around. The flame fist was my last resort. I'm so afraid. And so tired. I've been looking night and day everywhere I could. You will? Thank you. I haven't slept or eaten since she disappeared. I'm terrified something has happened to her. Her name is Vanra. She's 7 years old and has red hair, like me. We were in the Blushing Mermaid when she was taken. Just up by the docks. No, unless you count a couple of old drinking mates at the next table. But they'd be no help. They barely remember their own names. I was sober, though. I swear, I stop in the maid for a drink sometimes, but it was only a quick one. And of course, the front of house, Bosun Gannett was there, and the owner of the Blushing Mermaid, Captain Grizzly. Neither lifted a finger to help me look. It was awful. Thank you. I'll head home. Can't stand being around these idiots any longer. Come find me the moment you hear anything.
There's more flaming fist on the streets. I apologize for the hassle that woman caused. Such time wasters and troublemakers are a plague on the Flaming Fist.
As far as the eye can see.
Blaise Portier is perfectly fine. She's simply under tremendous pressure. There's nothing to worry about.
Yes? I have. And while I do not love my conclusion, that does nothing to change it. The Harpers are the city's best information network. With them out of action, we shall have to fall back on second best. Nine Fingers Keen.
A name known and feared throughout the city's underworld. The mysterious Keen runs the guild, which in turn runs every criminal enterprise in the city.
Nor are we. But I trust she knows the value of collaboration, especially in times like these. How hospitable she will be to a harper that comes begging to her guild hall, we will find out. Perhaps I will let you do the talking.
You're sure?
Later, then.
The tadpole quivers, revealing your discussion with Mazora to Will.
Shit. Father's been taken. And Mazora started to scheme. By all the hounds of the Hells, what is she planning? Mazora's always worth hearing out. That's what makes her so dangerous. We'll have answers soon enough. Let's talk to Mazora. Until then, may my father keep safe, whatever coop he's been flown to.
Baldur's Gate. You know, I never quite believed I'd actually make it back. It wasn't until we got within reach of Worm's Crossing that it felt real. It's so strange. I don't remember much of it, yet I can't help feel like I know it. It feels like home. I suppose it is. Though the chance to savor the moment might be brief, given all that still lies ahead of us. I may have to rely on your local knowledge to plug the gaps in my own mind. Hopefully, I'll remember more than I expect to. All right, some cup.
City is close now. My former peers will be watching, no doubt. Waiting for my return. We should.
I'm doing a little shopping in the city.
I think I may have overdone it.
Oh. Light
my entire life. Your look serves you well, though.
He's a man of the people, too.
Promise
at least
100 more watches.
There won't be you.
What do I think of Lord Gortash still
watch? I wonder if my old things are still there.
I am so glad you asked.
They could be of use to you.
No.
Hold up, citizen. This is a crime scene. No admittance.
The Vella's finished her report.
You can let them pass.
Probably best if I keep a low profile.
Hello, servant ape. Would you kill those rats, please? Their presence vexes me.
Just lying around, you furry chunkers.
Oh, look, Tambourine. A servant comes to help us. Kill those rats, would you? When they're dead, the other servants will feed us.
The cellars are just down the stairs. There, you'll find my old lodgings.
Spill some blood.
I'm ready.
So much for peace.
On the other side, you'll find a passageway, known only to those invited to do business.
Swift as my feet can carry me.
stirred.
The psionic detector's been activated. There must be Gith hostiles nearby.
Found us. Get rid of them quickly.
We must find evidence of its whereabouts.
All's well that ends not as bad as it could have.
Incoming.
Another fight. Let's go.
My little trick.
Let's turn someone inside out.
Feel.
Take you. Oh. Not going to last much longer.
Can't slow down. Die.
In position.
Enough sitting around. Let's go hurt someone.
Have to keep going.
My faith will guide me.
What to do? Never wanted the easy path. Something over there.
That's curious.
An old home. Thank you for bringing me back. Look around. You'll find some of my things still intact, perhaps even useful to you. My old sword, my first purchase as an adventurer. No use to me anymore. It's yours, if you want it. We are what we appear to be, and so appearances matter. butter knife is missing, but otherwise it looks to be complete. I don't need it anymore, but the memory stirs something in me still.
That's curious.
The chains I use to bind my meals. Villains and lawbreakers. You see, I tried to exercise morality where I could. An old container for brains. Empty. Shame. It would have been nice to find one to sustain me now.
Something over there.
Don't be shy.
Recipe for fiddlehead soup, a favorite meal of mine, when I had need of meals like that.
Still alive, so that's progress.
Rascal's collar, my poor four-legged friend. Their lives are so brief, so simple, and yet full.
Breathe deep and move.
It's not safe here. It's too late for me, but not for you. Run as fast as your legs can carry you. Orin happened. She seized me from our camp, bore me here to Baal's enclave. She slit my belly and filled her cup with my blood. A toast, she said, to her false god. She told me when her cup ran dry, she'd come for the rest of me. I'm done for. I will hold her off as long as I'm able. Run while you still can. Don't even think about fighting her. This foe is too powerful. You face her already.
Look at it, crawling and sniffing and rooting around in the filth. Is it my netherstone you seek, little piggy? Hush, hush. Orin will take care of you and your little pet. Gortash, the little lord of darkness. I know him well. Yes, yes, and he knows me. Knows how my blades sculpt and carve this city. I could peel a fine pelt from the mutt I caught sniffing at your heels. Drag skin from flesh, from bone. I will not slice. Her kind die too easily. The murder lord demands a better offering. Something new, sticky, sweet, and delicious. He wants you. The murder
murder lord does not need permission to kill. You are dull. A blunt blade unfit to flay. But you could be sharpened, thin and jagged. Yes, I will tell you what to do. Against the tyrant's throat, of course.
You heard Gortash's whispers. I see how your skull swarms with his promises. He whinges and wails over the crown of Karsus, wanting to command it without me. Oh, how I long to slit his poxy smile from ear to ear. But I can't touch him. He bound my blade when we first conspired. Gortash didn't want me at first. Didn't trust me. Got me to wag my tongue, swear an oath never to hang him from the hooks. Drip drain him into father's open jaws. You must kill the tyrant. Take the Netherstone from his corpse and bring it to my temple.
There, we slice and shred each other. The survivor claims the stones. What's left of the other is Baal's. Agree, and I will bring my assassins to heal. They watch you always, longing to spray the crimson from your veins. Refuse me, and you'll learn what happens to those who defy Baal's doctrine. So will your friend.
Orin demands a fight to the death. The prize for the victor, the Netherstones, and the chance to control the crown alone. Accept, and you must kill Gortash. Refuse, and your companion's life may be forfeit, as might your own. Orin's assassins will hunt you like prey for slaughter.
Allies? No, no. We had a balance. The chosen three. But it tumbled when you turned the Bone Lord to ash. Now, Gortash tries to gouge me from the city. That festering inadequate thinks me a flesher, butchering and cleaving only to whip the herd towards his tin men's oppression. You must kill him. Gore him like a pig prepped for the spit. Only then will you be sweet and sharp, ready for the murder lord's purpose. Need? No, no, no. I do not need. You are made of nothing. Meaningless flesh and bone, I do not need. I offer. Baal's age approaches, and you could be there to see it. An idol of flesh, made to welcome his bleeding dawn. There is time for you yet. Time to save. Do not underestimate his steel watch. Seek their cradle in the lower city and skewer their skull meat. Make them rust and blood. Then you can gore the lordling again and again and again. But listen, listen close, bone killer. Step in my domain while the tyrant still sucks air, and I will carve your failure into your pretty plaything's skull. Bring me his stone, and I will set the bait free. Only then can you and I make exquisite butchery. The victor will set the world to slaughter. That is Baal's offer.
He will not make another.
Watch your back. Let's crack it open.
Let's get going. Wonder if the gods are watching me.
We got rats in cellar. We also got cats, but cats are useless. So how about you kill the rats? You did? Very clever. Good job. Yes. Here, you take this. We're playing with... Hi, you already got paid. No more work here. Rats, murderers. Always knew the chef gig wasn't going to be easy. Do not worry. Chef Revere's eyes will be kept peeled for murdering types.
If any of these rooms are available to rent.
Oh, bollocks! I told those idiots not to let anyone through. You, name, rank, and reason for interrupting an active crime scene. For your sake, the last one better be bloody good. To fetch her another bottle of mead, no doubt. Yes, I'm Devella, the unfortunate colleague. Unless you've got useful information, leave me to my work. Duke Stalmain's dead, and I've got to find who killed her. Gods, that's it. Proof that I was right. I've been working on an assignment, see? A research project of sorts. I knew my conclusions were sound, but this... I never expected this. I'll tell you what I know. A century ago, there was a man. Saravok Anchev. He was a child of the god of murder, Baal. He ruled the Iron Throne. A dark tower hiding a darker secret. It was the front for a deadly arms-dealing network. There... Saravok amassed an army, and sought to become a god. Under his stewardship, the Baal Temple was revived. And with it, the Baal cult itself. Fortunately, the temple was destroyed. And to cleanse the city of Saravok's memory, the Iron Throne was torn from its foundations, and cast into the Chionthar. For most, that was the end of it. But cults like that don't disappear overnight. That list you spoke of confirms I'm right. The Baal cult is back. And someone is out there, continuing Saravok's work. Stranger things have come back to haunt this city. The brutality of the killings is on a par with Saravok's own. But there's something more here. Something new. There's a reference to these murders. A certain flair. It's as if they were done in worship. The precision of the cuts. The depth, the execution. The best butchers in Faerun couldn't make a cut like that. Trust me, I've asked them. I tried to explain all this to my superiors, but they wouldn't have any of it. They told me to drop it. Told me the city doesn't need another conspiracy theorist and to get back to doing my job before they find someone else to do it for me. But you... You're not bound by such constraints. Oh, help me out here. Help the city out. I bet if you follow the trail of these murders, you'll be able to unearth the truth of this resurgence. Believe me, I wish I could, but I need this job. There are patriarchs on the murder target list. I'm oath-bound to secure them first, so I'll be heading to the upper city next. While I'm there, the other potential victims will be at risk.
Could you warn them? Not from round here, are you? We're in Baldur's Gate. This is just how things work. Thank you. That's all I can ask, and more than I hoped. Once I'm done with the Patriarchs, I'll head to Basilisk Gate to have another go at convincing my superiors to put some resources into this matter. Meet me there if you've anything more to report. And good luck.
Bloodied ring. Guess the killer didn't want jewelry.
You do such a good job running the Gazette.
I wonder if any of these rooms are available to rent.
I'd live to perform for the greatest audience in the realms, the entirety of Baldur's Gate. Lycorissa lets me practice up here when she's on shift downstairs. She's too good to me. But you, I have a bone to pick with you, oh brave adventurer. Big trouble, the most trouble you've ever been in. I've decided I'm not going to perform in the Elf Song. Mainly because only the Elf Song itself is allowed to perform. I'm going to open up a school of bards, the best in the realms, to usher in a new age of magic and musicianship. And it's because of you that I dare to dream big enough. Thank you. That means a lot. I wanted to tell you first because, well, you inspired me to do it. Here. My very first lute, tuned to perfection. Thought you'd appreciate it when I'm rich and famous. Take care, my friend. Thank you for helping a bunch of ragtag tieflings in a druid's grove find their way home.
I wonder if any of these rooms are available to rent.
This red is the best wine in the entire Sword Coast.
In your dreams, more like.
Swallow a cork and die.
Why, hello there. We were just about to try some of Master Metzli's delightful wines. Would you care to join us?
Oh, they do look ever so tasty.
Ah, Mrs. Highbury, I prefer to conduct tastings individually, so I may assess your palate.
call me Cora, Master Metzley. And I'm afraid I must insist on their joining us. Wine's no good without company, after all.
No. I must say, if this is a practical joke, it's not very amusing.
Why, a serial killer? Oh, that's terrible. Master Metzley, are you quite all right?
It was perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. You have sullied it with knowledge, made it an unclean sacrifice. I will remember your face. And I will peel it from your skull should you interfere again.
Happy place.
Supposed to be enjoying the festival? We're working.
I've got it.
Are you drunk?
Not enough to listen to your prowl.
Fire, baby.
Before he strikes again.
Why, yes, Edvard. Can I call you Edvard? Well, Edvard, I do support Lord Gortash's campaign for several reasons.
is it today?
Say anything about the horrible present of Baldur's Gate, city of crime and chaos.
Wish I bloody knew. His job's a six-hander. What did we can't do it without dark, him.
Dark another one who can't it's take a bit of hard need. Work.
You're smelling. You may be allergic. But better safe than sorry, I suppose.
You, darling. You're just as rich as the day I married you.
No way to run a business, I say. Can't even browse while he's with a client.
A man cannot stroll the
Breeze there. Must be blowing inland today, bringing in the stench of the foundry.
It's unusual for prey to supply the tools of its own butchery. Razors, scissors, nail files. So many cuts one couldn't make. And yet, such a fleeting window. But then, who am I to deny the auspices of destiny? For we are celebrating, Master Figaro. You have the delicious honor of being my crowning achievement. Your body is my ultimate gift to my lord, Baal. Together, we shall transcend. Challenger, my lord tests me. This piteous hovel will be your grave, Challenger.
So you stopped here?
Yes, mostly. Why did you stop killing?
A moment longer. I felt like I was going to
fail. Fair enough. And they'd probably chuck you in the river if you did.
Probably.
I will savor your final breath.
My last kill
before becoming.
Done.
run a business, I say. Can't even browse while he's with a client.
What do you mean? What else is down?
I don't know. Magic, isn't it? I'm just saying, maybe there's a reason.
Step quick.
Breathe deep and move.
I must say, I'm damn lucky you showed up when you did. Can you believe what that monster was doing? I'll confess, it terrified me greatly. Can you imagine dressing entirely in red? Jests aside, thank you. You forever have my humblest gratitude and a most generous discount on my wares. In the face of such horror, I don't see that I have much choice. Now, how may I help you today? I sell anything and everything needed to cultivate your countenance. The best you'll find in Baldur's Gate. Certainly better than any dreck you'll pick up in Worms Crossing. Very good, sir. Remember, fashion's a fickle mistress, so be sure to return.
I should have known it would be you. Thank you. If it had been the dwarf alone, we might have stood a chance. But these doppelgangers, they swarmed us. We were paralyzed before we even had the chance to fight back. I was heading that way after we last spoke, when I heard a commotion. I stepped in to see what was going on. It's not every day you have the chance to catch a killer in action. Not even in this profession. These killings aren't random. In fact, they seem to be part of some sort of test. That document you showed me before, the one with the victims' names on it, that was the briefing. The killers paralyze their victims, take their hands as an offering for Baal, and make it look like the cult of the Absolute was behind it all. It grants them access to a tribunal. From what I could gather, it's some sort of rite of initiation for aspiring cultists to prove their worth. And it's taking place beneath Candlehallow's tombstones. Like I said before, it's not something I can look into in an official capacity. But you... How did you... Perhaps it's best I don't ask. Do what you have to do. And I'll pick up where I left off. The Upper City. When I'm done, I'll stop by the Basilisk Gate. If you've got any...
Through the river, I mean.
Maybe. I don't know how closely they watch it. But... There's probably grates and things down there to keep trash like us out.
Nah, you're right. And I'm not the best swimmer anyway. Gods know what else is down there and all.
There's clanking great steel.
A path of graves, sicarius, and a location.
That's what the mouth says.
We should find this Candlehallow place.
What else is down there?
Ah, a surface dweller. You find yourself in the cradle of all knowledge relating to the Underdark. The Society of Brilliance.
Tell me, what can the Society do for you?
A wonderful research partnership. I'm sure you'll agree. They are upstairs if you wish to share any theories with them. Yes, dear Lady Esther, one of our most reliable contractors. Though unfortunately, this particular request was too much even for her. Once the dust is settled on this whole invading army mess outside the walls, I'll find another contractor. Perhaps they will have more success.
Was there anything else?
I should really get back. Feel free to explore the lock. Genetic morality is not just theory, but fact.
My surface-dwelling friend, how long has it been?
I am glad to see you well. I see your tadpole remains in its state of suspension. Your case has set us on quite the detour from our planned expedition work. We've thought about very little else. In the field seeking further subjects for study, though it has been gone for longer than I anticipated. After observing the nature of your tadpole's stasis, we felt it wise to report back to the society. Omeloam went out into the city to seek out further undeveloped infections like yours, but I have heard nothing since. I admit, I'm somewhat concerned. We are usually sticklers for updating one another on our progress. Omeloam believed the answer to this riddle lay within the city walls and held some connection to the cult of the Absolute. I had the distinct impression it was intentionally keeping its hypothesis from me, as though even the theory would be enough to put me in danger. Why that would be, I can only theorize myself. It is rather outside my area of expertise. Omeloam is most likely safe and well, and simply absorbed in its work. However, it would put my mind at rest to confirm it if you happen across its path. Naturally, the Underdark provided us with some most unusual salvage. Plenty to keep an inquiring mind busy. Research. Your tadpole's stasis is a most cure. Omeloam believed the I. Why? Omeloam is most. Of course.
I'll admit it. I'm jealous of Blurg's talent.
No pissing or shitting. If you break it, you pay for it. Any fighting and Captain Grizzly will shank you. Got it? Gods above. Not again. You pull a knife on me like the last one and you're getting a boot, you hear? That woman, Lara, Laura, whatever her bloody name is, she was screaming her head off about some kid. Tore the place apart. Ooh, bloody disturbing. Captain Grizzly had to clock her in the end. Threw her out on her arse. Good riddance.
Hung over in peace.
Oh. Why, hello there. Captain Grizzly at your service. What can I do for a long drink of water like yourself? Oh, not this claptrap again. Listen, Laura was here, all right? Knocking back pints like there's no tomorrow. But she was alone. I saw head nor ass of this so-called kid, and when we tried to kick her out, she pulled a knife on my front man. Bet she didn't tell you that bit, huh? That's because she's taking you for a ride. And not the fun kind. Look, I know Laura from my pirating days. She ran with Bart Blackdagger's crew. Heard they tossed her overboard when she gutted the bosun over a game of cards. Now, I'd no beef with her before this. All are welcome in the maid. But threatening my staff, claiming we took her kid, she's bonkers. Dangerous. Next time she pulls a knife on me and mine, someone might die. Something has to be done. Gods! Do I have to spell it? She's dangerous. And I couldn't call myself a captain if I stood by and did nothing. I hate that it's come to this. But I'll pay a hoard of gold to whoever scuppers her. Permanently. Oh, you're no fun.
Oh, well. Guess I'll just decorate the room with your insides. They'll match my new carpet beautifully. Hello, Petal. Miss me? You made a mockery of me, you little shit. Besting me in my own home. Did you think I would simply walk away? Marina ran off with the child I was promised because of you. So I had to find myself a new one. And little Vanra was so very tasty. Oh. She'll thank me for it. Venra sits in my belly, growing fat with power. In time, I'll vomit her up and have myself a fresh young hag to train. Unfortunately, that leaves me in a pickle. For while I'd love to rip your guts out, I shouldn't. Exertion is bad for the baby, you know. So, walk away. Walk away and let me a fine hag make. You want to negotiate? You lost that privilege when you humiliated me, you little shit. Stay and die, or walk away and live. Or what? You'll kill me, touch me, and the girl dies. And I'll simply return, stronger than ever. woman in my condition should be relaxing in the bath, not dealing with this nonsense. I leave you to my crew, matey. And should you somehow survive, stay away, or Vanna will suffer.
To press ahead.
Done. under their noses.
Ethel again. I was hoping she'd found some remote bolt to rot in.
Did they get you? Are you right?
We'll find Dad.
Don't mind me. Where in the hell's this grizzly? What were those monsters? If there is so much as a scratch on you, I'm going to ruin Grizzly.
Dad, breathe. I'm all right. And you, thank you for stopping those, whatever they were.
These boots have seen everything.
In Beato.
You've heard of such devils. Sisters of justice. Adjudicators of diabolical contracts and bargains.
Holy hells.
You do not call upon the sisters. They come when the hells demand witness.
Your parasite links with Will's, and your memories flow into him. He sees his father's flight from Worm's Rock, and hears Mizora's words to you.
Shit! Where did Gortash send my father? How do I save him?
Sisters.
Infernos contractos te vocamus. Infernos contractos te vocamus. Infernos contractos te vocamus.
Your contract, Will. Signed in blood, forged in fire, bound in bone, but not unbreakable. A life for a life. No contract is ended without sacrifice. The cost must be paid. Will Ravenguard, a choice is before you. Option one, I show you the way to your father. I guarantee him no harm except that from you and your allies. And you pledge your soul to me and the Archdevil Zariel in a pact eternal. Option two, I break your pact and you are freed from your duty. Your father dies by his enemy's hand, and Baldur's Gate loses its greatest champion. Name your sacrifice.
Bloody Zariel. I won't let her take Will.
Silence, Karlak.
Mizora, you asshole.
Choose. Addendum F. The Absolute must be avenged for the Soulbinder's detention at Moonrise. The Soulbearer retains his gifts until such time as the Absolute is slain.
You damned wretch! Father. Do it. Break the pact.
Fiat ita.
Fiat ita. Anima ad beator.
Didn't think you had it in you. Seems my boy's all grown up. And don't go fussing about your father. You made your choice. You knew the terms. You know what? I think I'll stick around. Not for the greater good, you understand. Just for the entertainment.
gods. I spent 7 years choked by Mazura's leash. And I spent 7 years hoping to break free. I never knew freedom could taste so bittersweet. I didn't. I don't. My sacrifice kept Baldur's Gate safe from Tiamat's rage. But that doesn't mean that the leash never chafed. That I was content to lap up whatever nonsense Mazura fed me. The leash has been broken and my father left for dead. Tomorrow I celebrate my gain. But today, I mourn my loss.
A moment passes. In the stillness, you find a mote of tranquility.
The Raven Guard name now lives solely with me. I will make it count for something. I signed his life away before the Hell's Witnesses. It would be easier to drink the Styx down to the last drop than to alter his fate. I'd be a fool to wish otherwise. We obtain the final two Netherstones and take back our minds and the city from the Brain. Go on, then.
Little Will's all grown up. I can't wait to see what trouble he gets into. Well, not exactly, but it's only a matter of time. Don't be too hard on Will. I'm sure he carefully weighed the pros and cons. Pro, freedom. No more pact, no more hellbound soul. Con, killing off his own father, Baldur's Gate's most beloved duke, and forever altering the city's future. I would have done the same thing in his shoes. But what do I know about heroes? Just because he's not my pet, doesn't mean he's not useful. The Absolutists worked a number on me at Moonrise. And you're the best hope I've got at payback. No one crosses the Hell's Children without getting scorched. Ugh, you are an inquisitive one. I'd have thought you'd figured by now. Zariel found new use for an old battle axe. The dead three in that bulging brain of theirs are a threat to more than this trifling city, you know. Savor her company. Who's to say when Zariel might change her mind? My mistress can be so capricious. The nine hells of Beator, each its own domain. Each with its own archdevil to rule it. I call the first hell my home, Avernus. My mistress Zariel's realm, a torrid battleground split by the bloody waters of the Styx. How I adore it. The delicious agony of it all. The other eight, well, they are pleasures unto themselves. Perhaps I'll show you myself, if I deem you worthy. Correct. I didn't. If you must know, I was scouting the cultists on behalf of Zariel, but those cursed shadows were thick enough to fell even a half-fiend. I woke in that damned pod. It kept my body sealed and my most powerful magic silenced. But a brave, kind, benevolent soul set me free. Gallantry isn't dead, after all. Why? I'm supplying Will with every scrap of his infernal power. I've paid my dues many times over.
I tell you what. When the time comes to squish that big baddie of a brain, I'll lend you a hand.
Let's talk.
Will sacrificed his own father.
Fine. What's on your...
How are you holding up?
Figured it out. Exactly what I want to do with you. I want to go on a date. A first date. No weapons, no monsters, no mysterious voices. Just you and me and dinner.
Please say yes.
Yes! Oh, amazing. Put on your least bloody tunic and meet me back here. Oh, I'm so excited! Give me a beat to run ahead. I want to make sure everything's absolutely perfect. See you there. Hi. Hi! You made it! You look nice. Thank you. Baldurian seafood stew. No, thank you. What do you think you'll have? Just what I had in mind. Two of the Rothe ribs, please. And two glasses of... And two glasses of beer. So, you're an adventurer, right? How's that going? This is our first date, remember? Tonight, you're a mystery to me. It's all I can do to keep my hands to myself anyway. We're terrible at this. Show me your ways. Oh, that's easy. During year two of my fabulous adventure in celibacy in Avernus, I once got so, pent up, I burnt down my field tent. Blamed it on an imp and never told a soul the truth. Beat that. We'll have to make some new secrets between us then. Oh, hey, here comes our food. Hey, Henk, I think we ordered the...
Jablader.
Worst guy I ever met. Anyway, how about a toast? Oh, shit! May we live every day like it's our last. never know when your last will come. Oh, that was great. The food and the company.
Whatever do you mean? We're just two normal people living normal lives, very, very normally.
I know I can't stay forever here with you. In fact, I feel like I don't have long left at all. We've been through so much, and the worst is yet to come. I have every reason to feel terrified, hopeless, like giving up. But to be here, with you, in the city I love, in this world that I love so much, it's all I could really ask for. You hear me? You're all I could ever ask for. I love you. And I know that whatever else this city will throw at us, we can handle it.
Come on, there's something I want to show you upstairs. No, after you.